nearly 2 years after one of the worst recessions in our history, certainly the worst one in our lifetimes. Our economy is showing signs of real strength.
It's been 21 months since the recession ended, and we are still down 7.2 million non-farm payroll jobs from when it started.
President Obama and Republican Congressman Kevin Brady with very different views today of the nation's jobs picture. And it's time to bring in our panel, Steve Hayes from the Weekly Standard, Kirsten Powers of the New York Post, and syndicated columnist Charles Krauthammer. Well, the big numbers about the economy are that it added a net in March of 216,000 jobs, and the unemployment rate ticked down from 8.9% to 8.8%. But let's put up the numbers inside the numbers. The unemployment rate has dropped a full percentage point in the last 4 months. That's the biggest decline since 1983. The private sector has added 1.8 million jobs in the last 13 months, but there are still 13.5 million Americans unemployed. So, is it good news, very good news, or great news?
I think far more good news than bad news. I think if you look at the past 6 months' worth of job reports, you could have made the argument that essentially we were treading water. I think this suggests that at least on jobs, at least in this snapshot, we're no longer just treading water. Anytime you're over 200,000, that's really heading in the right direction. The bigger problem, I think, for the Obama administration is that there are so many other indicators that the economy is not growing as quickly as we'd like it to, contrary to what the president said there. I mean, you had yesterday Robert Reich, former labor secretary in the Clinton administration, saying that we were heading for a double-dip recession. Consumer confidence is plummeting. Energy prices are rising. Food prices are going up. All of these things that would, you know, I think restrict what consumers are going to do, how they're going to spend the money, their money, is a big long-term downer.
On the other hand, Kirsten, Austin Goolsbee, the chairman of the Council of Economic Advisers today, was sent out by the White House, and he talked about the fact that the administration had projected 2.7% growth this year, 3.6% next year. He said they now think that those numbers are too low and they're going to revise them upwards. So he seems to indicate, despite all of these drags and certainly the unrest in the Middle East and oil prices are drags, that the economy, the rebound is chugging along.
Yeah, and definitely the people that I spoke to today at the White House reiterated that they seem very happy. I think they would call it great news. They especially because they see this as being something that's beginning a trend. And so it's not just a one-off number, that it's something that they think they're finally getting that, you know, the jobs are the lagging indicator in the recovery, and finally we're starting to see that. And so they see this as being on the upswing.
Charles, do you see a trend here?
Well, from what I hear from economists I respect, it looks as if these numbers indicate a self-sustaining recovery. And if this continues, the downward slope in unemployment, you could project it to November of next year, where it would be way below 8%, and that would be a real positive for the administration. The one real negative on the horizon is in part oil, but also general inflation and commodity inflation, for two reasons. Number one, obviously it takes some money out of everybody's pocket, whether it's a consumer or a business that's got high cost in transportation and has to pass on. So that's a drag on the economy. Billions are going overseas. But secondly, if inflation picks up, you're going to have to get a rise in interest rates. The European Central Bank is talking about raising its rates. Its inflation is now higher. And once you've got a rise of interest rates, that's going to be a second drag on the economy. If that happens, then all of this could stall out at the end of the year.